Everybody likes taking pictures in the hills. It's a totally natural thing to do. Of course it is. It's an amazing landscape. It's spectacular. And you want to remember your day out. But it's one thing taking pictures that you'd be happy to show your mates and look at from time to time. And it's quite another thing taking pictures that you want to stick on the wall and show to people for years. Here's a few tips on how to take a better hill picture. One of the easiest ways to instantly improve your hill photography is just to think hard about what time you're going out into the hills. If you go out early or you stay out late, you're going to get a lovely low-angled sun, and that makes for much better light in the hills. Also, there's going to be fewer people in the hills as well, so you most likely have them to yourself, and these are really, really magical hours for photography. Go out in the middle of the day and quite often you get an overhead sun, which isn't very flattering and makes things look a little bit flat and characterless. Point and shoot compact cameras are small and light and easy to use, but they generally have poorer lenses than SLR cameras or single lens reflex cameras like this. The SLR cameras have lots of manual functions as well, so they really allow you to be a bit more creative with your photography. SLR cameras have got all kinds of cool functions. They allow you to set slower shutter speeds so you can add creative effects like blur and also record night scenes with the use of a tripod, for instance. You can also change the lenses on these cameras as well, and you can see exactly what you're looking at from looking through the viewfinder because you're actually looking through the lens. They also allow you to manually focus, so you can have some things in the picture in focus and some things out of focus, which can make for really, really interesting photographs. The great thing about SLR cameras is they really, really allow you to develop your skills, but almost all of them have still got an automatic function that allows you to just point and shoot. And there are a few little accessories that you can add to an SLR camera, even on automatic mode, which will produce really, really stunning pictures with hardly any effort at all. They allow you to use filters. Now, there are two filters that the outdoor photography has to have in their gadget bag. One of them is a grey grad filter, and the other is a polarizing filter. Have you ever taken any photographs that have horribly burnt out white skies and nice detailed foreground? That's the problem that you solve using a grey grad filter. What this filter does, as you'll see, half of it is smoked and half of it is clear. Now, this doesn't put a colour cast on your photograph. All it does is it lowers the exposure in the sky to a level that the camera can interpret. Therefore, you don't lose detail from the sky. It's pretty hard to describe what a grey grad filter does. So what I'm going to do, you see those moody clouds up there? That's how a grey grad can really, really define a sky. A polarizing filter cuts glare and reduces unwanted reflections in a picture, and it really, really saturates rich colors, especially later in the day or earlier in the day. Now, it's a little harder to demonstrate what a polarizing filter does, but if you take a look at these pictures, you can see in the first picture, we've got a fairly watery blue sky. In the second picture, that sky is really, really rich and saturated. Now, polarizing a filter achieves this effect by slotting in the front of the camera, and then as you rotate the filter on the lens, you can actually see the difference happening through the viewfinder. So, you've found the right camera for you, you've found your location, you've got out there nice and early, it's time to take your picture. Now you've got to think about composition. Whatever you're taking a picture of, whether it's a mountain or a person on a mountain, is that subjects rarely look good in pictures when they're dead center in the frame. One of the most important rules of composition is known as the rule of thirds. The next time you look through your camera viewfinder, imagine the viewfinder divided into 9 individual segments. Try placing the main elements, such as the horizon or the eyes of a portrait, on or near the points where these lines intersect. The rule of thirds is great for landscape photography, but if you're taking photographs of people, another good skill a photographer has got to have is finding the right angle. When you're taking pictures of your mates, don't just stand right in front of them. Find the best angles, whether it's from the side, or below, behind, or above. Might get on your friend's nerves to start with, but they'll thank you for it later when they've got a great picture to show for it. So there we go. Follow these simple tips, you're guaranteed better hill pictures. And one last thing, don't forget to smile.